Welcome to this ANSYS Innovation course on the microstrip patch antenna. And as you saw in the introduction, the microstrip patch antenna is commonly used in the 5G ADAS or V2X antenna systems, and therefore its design is a very important component in the safety and reliability of these systems. In its most fundamental form, a microstrip patch antenna consists of a radiating patch on one side of a dielectric substrate, and which has a ground plane on the other side. And the patch is generally made of conducting materials such as copper or gold, and it could take any possible shape. And that radiating patch and the feed lines are usually etched on the dielectric substrate, but there's also research on 3D printed antennas and the use of metamaterials. Microstrip patch antennas radiate primarily because of the fringing fields, the fringing electric fields between the patch edge and the ground plane. And the length of the patch is a very critical parameter because this dictates the resonant frequency of the antenna structure. And by definition, it should be about a half a wavelength in the dielectric. So the length is about a half a lambda in the material, plus some delta L that accounts for the fringing effects. And the width is about half a lambda as well in the material, plus some delta L, again counting for the fringing, and that dictates the input impedance to the antenna. Of course, desirable is 50 ohms, but depending on the substrate used, it can be very wide. So what exactly is that fringing field? And so the plots here are the vector plots that describe the electric field, and the colors signify the magnitude, red being a high intensity and blue being a lower intensity. Fields are not all directed normally between the conducting surfaces. Some fields are allowed to radiate outward in a fringing fashion. This fringing effect, which is due to the path of that electric field, those lines make those antennas look larger or wider than it physically is. And the main cause of fringing can be due to the width and the position of the feed point to that antenna. And as we can see, the microstrip antenna is characterized by its length and its width. And these dimensions are dependent also on the material properties of the dielectric between them. By the patch antenna design equation, we can see that the resonant frequency is inversely proportional to the patch length. As you can see from this plot, as you increase the length of the patch, the resonant frequency goes down. Another characteristic of a microstrip antenna is that it propagates in a quasi-TM mode. Why? Because the fields in the air above the patch and in the dielectric are not the same. And as you can see from these plots, you can see that the fields in the dielectric is more than the fields above in the air. An important factor in the design of 5G or ADAS antenna systems is the polarization. For these systems, with many reflections and interferences, a linear polarization is necessary. So polarization is defined as the direction of the wave as it propagates between the transmitter and the receiver. And there are three types of polarization. There's elliptical, there's circular, and there's linear. In general, antennas like to radiate in an elliptical polarization. An antenna radiates elliptically polarized wave when the field vector, whether it's electric or magnetic, for that transmitted wave from the antenna has two unequal orthogonal linear components, and the phase difference between them is an odd multiple of 90 degrees. And when the field vector, again electric or magnetic, for that transmit wave has two orthogonal linear components with the same magnitude, and the phase difference between them is an odd multiple of 90 degrees, then that antenna has a circular polarization. The antenna that's linearly polarized is when the field vector, again electric or magnetic, for the transmitted wave of the antenna only has one component or two orthogonal linear components that are in time phase, or they're 180 degrees or multiples of 180 degrees out of phase. For good antenna performance, typically a thick dielectric substrate having a very low dielectric constant is desirable. Why? Because this provides a better efficiency, a larger bandwidth, and and a better radiation pattern. But this configuration tends to be a large antenna size. The lower the material epsilon R, the more fringing, so there's more radiation. So in order to design a compact microstrip patch antenna, the substrates with the higher dielectric constants must be used, but this configuration is also less efficient and they result in narrower bandwidth. So a trade-off must be realized between the antenna dimension, physical space, and the antenna performance. So various parameters of the microstrip antenna and its design considerations were discussed in this video. And for ADAS, we want low profile and high gain microstrip antennas. And of course, easy and cheap to manufacture. Thank you for watching this video. And to find more information about antennas in HFSS, or topics like ADAS or V2X or 5G, check our ANSYS Learning channel for more videos. Visit ANSYS.com/courses today.